Welcome Bitcoin friends, it's Bitcoin Memo. Today we're going to look at the Bitcoin charts, do some TA, look at various time frames, and we'll also take a look at Market Cipher. We have seen a decent correction for Bitcoin in the last few days. And I just want to start here looking at the US stock market. This is the S&P 500 futures chart. We are on the 2-week time frame. And in the previous video, we mentioned that we might get a pullback here on the stock market. We were at this golden pocket area, taking the Fib from this high down to our low. And we also noted this trend line just connecting the overall highs here and this 2-week order block. So there was some confluence between all three of these, and it looked like this was a good point where the stock market might have a pullback after we had this nice approximately 20% rally. But over to Bitcoin now, and we have seen the hash ribbon buy signal appear. This is something we've been waiting for. The hash ribbon indicator shows when miners are capitulating and selling their Bitcoin. And when that starts happening, we do see these two lines here cross over and we get this red cloud here. We also get these circles appearing. And most times when this cloud closes off and these lines cross over again, it triggers the hash ribbon buy signal. And we've been looking at previous bear markets here. We have the 2014-15 bear market. And I've just highlighted that in white, taking it from the bull market peak to the bear market low. Also the 2018 bear market here and our current cycle from what we noticed with the hash ribbon indicator. Typically towards the end of the bear market, we start getting this signal flashing. And once we get that buy signal, it generally indicates that the previous low was the bottom of the bear market. So just zooming in on the 2014-15 bear market here, we started getting the hash ribbon signal flashing here. We had that one more capitulation. The low came on this candle here, and then we did get that buy signal a few candles later. We do also have Market Cipher pulled up down the bottom here, and this is on the 2-week time frame. And we're also watching for this major 2-week green dot to appear. As we noticed with the two previous bear markets, like the hash ribbon buy signal, these 2-week major green dots are also a good indication that the bottom of the bear market is in. Just looking at the 2018 bear market now, we had the miners starting to capitulate here. We had that one more final capitulation down. We got the hash ribbon buy signal on this candle, and the previous low was the bottom of the bear market. We also had that 2-week major green dot at the same time. And looking at our current bear market, whether we look at this as the high of the bull run or this high, either way, we've been in this downtrend for quite a while now. We did get that major 2-week green dot here on this candle, and we're waiting for that hash ribbon buy signal to appear. Miners started capitulating around this area. We had that one more final capitulation. And now we do have that hash ribbon buy signal along with the 2-week major green dot confirmed. And based on the previous two bear markets, this has indicated that the previous low was the bottom of the bear market. And that low was at around 17.6K. So I don't expect us to go lower than this level now. Another thing to note in the 2018 bear market here, we did see the low got put in here. We had a nice rally off of that. And then we had this big red candle to the downside. And that's what ended up triggering the hash ribbon buy signal. You can see we went a little bit lower, but we did form a higher macro low. And this would have been a really good entry for a long-term long position here. And we also see with our current bear market, we had this nice rally from 17.6K to 25K. Now we have had this big red candle here. And that also triggered the hash ribbon buy signal. So we are looking for a higher macro low here, and there are a few different levels we can look at. This is actually on the log scale. I do prefer to use the linear scale, but we can take a look at both. The one thing we could possibly look out for here is if we just connect these two lows, we can see we lost that trend line. We have reclaimed it. So perhaps we're going to come back down and test this trend line again. On next week's candle, that would be down at around 19.7K. And on the week after that would be around 19.4K. I do also have this white dotted trend line. And this is just connecting the overall lows here. The bottom of the stock market crash. And also this low from the 2014-15 bear market. And these are the two lowest points we can connect here. And we do see we did get pretty close to that line, depending on what chart you use. We do see that there's a bit of an intersection around this area. So this could possibly be an area where we might wick down to. But I do think anything under 20K will get bought up quite quickly. And I think a lot of people are looking to buy below 20K. So here we are on the weekly chart for Bitcoin, back on the linear scale rather than the log scale. And we can see that macro falling wedge pattern, two touches on the top, two on the bottom. Generally, we break bullish on the third touch on the upside. So we are still looking to break above this trend line at some time. Could take several weeks here. Breaking this trend line would also cement that the bottom is in. But just looking at our more immediate price action over the last few months here, we can see how much Bitcoin dropped here from around 25.2K down to 20.8K. And there was a lot of liquidations on this drop. So it did wipe out a lot of the over-leveraged longs, causing a bit of a cascade on that drop. We do also notice we are now below the 200-week moving average in red, which was at 23K. I don't think this is a big issue. I think we probably hang around this moving average for a while. We do also have this channel drawn, just connecting the overall lows here and also this high. We can see on this drop down, we did get close to the bottom of the channel. We didn't quite touch it here. On next week's open, the bottom of this channel would be at 20.9K. But I want to point out the weekly order blocks here. I think these are quite important. We do have these order blocks lower down. We can see this order block here did act as support on the pullback, and the bodies of the candles did close inside this order block. These order blocks come from way back in 2020 on the initial bull run. These order blocks are areas of supply and demand. They can act as resistance or support levels. It's a break in a trend. They come from a green candle in a downtrend or a red candle in an uptrend. And time was spent here and therefore volume. And so these can act as support or resistance levels. And if we just pull up the VPVR, we can see we do have a bit of a spike around this area near these order blocks, also at this thin order block here and this one lower down. What I've noticed with a previous price action is when we do have an order block inside another order block, quite often we do come back to that, and it can be a point where we do get a bounce and turn around. And it has been quite accurate if you back test it. We can see how we pretty much did that exactly here. We did wick down to the bottom of this middle order block from this red candle, and we have bounced from around 20.8K to currently 21.2K. But we might spend some time around this area as we form a bottoming pattern, but that'd be better to look at that on the smaller term time frame with the daily chart. But I do think this is a key order block that we need to hold. And again, this is looking at weekly closes. So we can possibly wick down lower, but still close the weekly inside these order blocks. The bottom of the order block here is at 20,560. If we do close below this order block and also this channel, then I would expect us to revisit some of these lower order blocks. There is one here at 19.2K and one lower down at 18.3K. Another thing to point out is looking at the Fib levels, taking it from the overall low here to our high point. Do see that golden pocket here just below these order blocks. So quite often we do pull back to that golden pocket area. I do think it's possible we may be wick down into this golden pocket area. But again, I think we'll close the weekly candles inside this order block or above it. And just looking at the overall price action here, these are those other two order blocks lower down from both of these red candles. But we do notice here from these order blocks that we do have a big spike on the VPVR down around that 19K area, and a similar spike here where we got this pullback at around 24K. So there is support lower down, and again, I don't think we'll break below the previous low here at 17.5K. Now that we have that hash-driven buy signal and also the two-week major green dot confirmed. And for me personally, I'm looking for a possible long position here that I might be able to hold long-term in the bull run. I did actually short from 24K, and I have taken most of those profits. But I think entering a long around this area between 21 and 20K, even possibly having some orders lower down to catch some wicks, be a really good long entry for a long-term position. But I would recommend low leverage, so you can comfortably have your stop loss below here without losing too big of a percentage, if I'm wrong and we do come down to this area. So for me, I might put in a 3 or 4x leverage trade with half of what I want to put in, around 21 to 20k area around this order block. And then if we do drop lower, I would enter the other half of the position lower down. And again, with the stop loss below this low at 17.6K. Just to show you a similar long-term trade here, I do have a trade actually that I put on after the stock market crash. I did get into the trade on this pullback here. And so I have been holding this trade since March of 2020. So almost 2.5 years. That trades at 5,900 approximately. And I did actually have two trades at that level at the time on a different account here. This one was at a similar level at around 6,800. And moving on to the total crypto market cap now. We have been talking about this yellow box here, which just captures this range of this consolidation on the initial run up here in the bull run. We mentioned we might spend some time in this yellow box before breaking this trend line on this falling wedge, which is more of a channel pattern on the total crypto market cap. What's different compared to the Bitcoin chart is this is the 200-week moving average in red. We can see we did hold it here pretty much with the bodies of the candles. We are still above that 200-week moving average. We do have an order block here in the blue from this green candle in a downtrend. And I do think we could possibly come down to this area on the total crypto market cap. And that doesn't necessarily mean that Bitcoin drops lower. It can mean that the altcoins start dropping while Bitcoin goes sideways. We also have the golden pocket here, close to that 200-week moving average, and this order block. We can also pull up the VPVR, the amount of volume traded at certain price levels. And we do see two big spikes here further down. So I do think we do come down into this area. And onto the daily chart for Bitcoin now. We have that macro falling wedge pattern drawn in. And in the previous video, we were around this area. We had this rising wedge pattern drawn in, which is a bearish pattern. And we were watching for a daily close below that. And we were also watching the RSI. We had a similar trend line drawn in here. And we said if we close below this trend line and also below this rising wedge pattern, I would expect us to have a correction. And there were two possibilities. We thought we might get a bounce from this daily order block in blue here from this green candle in a downtrend. Otherwise, if we broke this range where we also had order blocks on the 5 and 6 day time frame, then I expected us to come down to this lower area where we do have this order block from this red candle in an uptrend. We also had order blocks on different time frames, which I do have drawn in here. So we can get rid of this pattern now, and we're just looking at this white dotted trend line, just connecting the overall lows. We can see that we did close slightly below it here, and now I have gotten back inside that area. We are also inside this daily order block. We didn't close below it, which is a good sign. Now we need to close back above this daily order block, back above 21.2, to give confidence that it acted as support. And the bottom of the order block is at around 20,800. And we do also have those fib levels drawn in, taking it from the overall low here to the high. And we see that golden pocket at 20.2K to 20.5K. We do also have some other daily order blocks down here in the golden pocket area. This one comes from this green candle in a downtrend, and this one from this red candle in an uptrend. So again, we could possibly wick down to this golden pocket and some of these order blocks, but I think on the weekly, we will end up closing up higher here. We do actually have the weekly order block drawn in purple here, and that's what we talked about earlier. We have this smaller order block inside this bigger order block on the weekly time frame. I've just drawn these in on the daily chart here. So this is when the new weekly candle opens on the 22nd of August. So we don't want to close below this order block, below 20.5K, when we do open that new weekly candle. and also have these other boxes drawn in here. This is the 6-day order block, and it starts the day after the weekly open. So on Tuesday, we see it covers a similar range. And then the 5-day order block here, there is actually two, one here and one with the bigger rectangle. So again, an order block inside an order block. So we do see several order blocks here along with the daily one. So there is some confluence here. And as long as we don't close below these order blocks on the relevant time frames, then we have to assume they're acting as support, and we would need to close above these order blocks on the relevant time frames to give the confirmation that it has acted as support. But the first one to watch would be this daily order block, obviously, with the bottom of it at 20.8K. And we'll have to see if we close the daily at least inside this order block, both on today's close and tomorrow's close. And on Monday's open, we'll be watching both of these weekly order blocks. And just pulling up the VPVR on the more shorter term price action here, we do also see the spike between 21.6K and 20.1K. And this all lies in that area of all these order blocks to be a key area that we need to hold, also above this golden pocket area. And over to the Bitcoin futures chart here on CME. And the thing to note that was different with the futures chart is we didn't come down to that 17.6K area. It did happen over the weekend. So the futures chart only came to 18.5K. So it does look a little bit different. We had that same rising wedge pattern, which we did break. So we can now get rid of that pattern. But something to note here is doing the Fib on the futures chart from the low to our high. We do actually have the golden pocket at around 21K. And we can see that's where we've pretty much come to at the moment. This was also the area on this pullback. We are looking to try to get some support on this area. Of course, the futures chart is closed over the weekend. We'll have to see where we open on Monday if we do open above this golden pocket, above at least 20.9K. And if we pull up the VPVR, we do see a strong level of support here, also in line with that golden pocket area. And over to Market Cipher now. This is on the 4-hour chart. This is our drop from 25K down to 21K. You can see we got this major green dot here on the 4-hour time frame, but it was less reliable as we had dipped into the red money flow here. And also the higher term time frames are more reliable with the major green dots. We did get another 4-hour major green dot here that did get confirmed. And the thing to watch for here is the money flow. We want to see this start curving around and coming back up into the green. And we can watch the money flow on the smaller term time frames as an earlier indication that we are going to start moving back to the upside, and also give more confidence on the major green dots on the higher term time frames. The 6-hour also got this major green dot confirmed, but again, we see this money flow coming down and we need to see it start to curve to the upside to give more confidence. The 12-hour time frame doesn't have a major green dot yet. It is getting close though, perhaps in the next few candles, and the money flow is also in the red. So I think the key time frame to watch here is the daily time frame. You do see this blue wave is still coming down here. It does look like it's got a bit more to go on it. So it might take a couple of days here until we can see a green dot on the daily time frame, and we may spend some time going sideways here. Perhaps look for some bullish divergence on the 4-hour time frame. But I think the green dot on the daily will be more reliable as we are still in the green money flow here. And we were in the red money flow for quite a long time, ever since we were back at 40K. The 2-day time frame did get this red dot. It did get confirmed on the 19th of August. We are still in the red money flow here and have been ever since we were back at 47K. Although this looks bearish here, if we do get that green dot on the daily time frame, it may provide the momentum for this blue wave to get another green dot on the 2-day. And there is also the higher time frames like the weekly and the 2-week, which are quite bullish, can provide support to the time frames below them. The 3-day is similar. We got that red dot. It has been confirmed. The 4-day also has a red dot here. Next 4-day candle is after today's close. It does look like this will get confirmed. But again, we need to see that green dot on the daily, hopefully get some momentum from that to turn around the 2 day, then the 3 day, then the 4 day, and so on. The 5 day also has a red dot, but that won't be confirmed till the 24th of August. And again, we can look at these order blocks that we did mark out, the 5 and the 6 day and the weekly ones, and use those as an indication. If we do close below those order blocks on the relevant timeframes, we can use that in confluence with Market Cipher. The 6 day doesn't have any red dots present yet. And the same with the weekly time frame. So we do still have bullish momentum on the weekly here, after getting this major green dot confirmed on the 11th of July. And just looking at the money flow here in red, we do see it has been curving back around. We're looking for that to get back into the green. If we do look at the previous bear markets in 2018, we saw the money flow dip into the red. Once it did cross into the green, we had already had this rally from 4K to 12K. Looking back at the 2014-15 bear market, this one seems a bit more similar here. We can see we dipped into the red money flow on the weekly time frame. We got that major weekly green dot here, and we saw that red wave start to curve around. And we noticed once it did cross into the green here, which was on this candle, it did indicate that we're going to start moving up in the next bull run and that this consolidation near the lows was over. We did see some choppiness with these red and green dots here after the major weekly green dot got confirmed. So this will be something to look out for, watching this money flow. If it does cross into the green, it would give a lot of confidence that we are going to start pushing higher. And finally, the 2 week time frame, we had that major green dot. It got confirmed on the 1st of August. And again, we noted in the previous two bear markets that this did indicate that the bottom was in. So I think that's about all. Hope you enjoyed that analysis. The thing to watch in the short term time frame here is on the daily chart here. We have that order block from this red candle in an uptrend, and we're looking to see if the daily can close above the bottom of this order block, above 20,800. And then on Monday, obviously, we have the new weekly open, and we're looking for the weekly to close at least above 20.5K. And if we do open next week below that level, it will show this order block hasn't acted as support, and then perhaps we can look for the lower price targets back down below 20K. But I do think it will get bought up quite quick, anything below 20K here. And the other order blocks to watch on the 6 day time frame, that will open on the Tuesday, the 6 day. The bottom of that order block is at 20,440. And then on Wednesday, the 5 day order block here will be relevant, and we need to stay above 20,550. So we'll have to wait and see what happens here. The weekend is a bit more unpredictable, and I think Monday will give us a better idea to see what the stock market does and if Bitcoin can get a bounce on the open on Monday. And remember, we do have that hash ribbon buy signal confirmed now, and previous bear markets indicated that the previous low was the bottom of that bear market. For me, the worst case scenario, if I'm wrong, is we form some sort of double bottom pattern here. But for me personally, I think anything under 20K will be bought up quick, and we'll just see a wick on the weekly candle and end up closing back above 20.5K on the weekly closes. So thanks for watching. I'm Bitcoin Mamo. I'll see you next time. Bye.